Hello, this is Mike Cassis from the CNE Security CXP team here at Microsoft. And for this microlearning video, I want to talk about just-in-time VM access, the exciting new feature in Azure Security Center that's now in public preview. Being able to remotely manage your virtual machines from anywhere in the world is a fantastic feature of cloud hosting. However, it also means that you have inbound ports open on these resources that are a prime target for attackers. In fact, RDP and SSH brute force attacks are some of the highest volume attacks we see in Azure. That's where just-in-time VM access comes in, and it's not just for management ports. JIT makes it easy to put any of your key inbound ports into a default deny state until an admin needs access. Then the admins can simply request a window of time where the ports will be open, and once that window expires, the ports are back to being locked down. This is a very simple yet powerful security feature and will greatly reduce your exposure to potential breaches and compromise. Let's look and see how this works. To get started using JIT, you'll need a few things. First, you'll need an Azure Security Center standard tier subscription, as JIT is not part of the free tier set of features. Second, you'll want to have at least a single VM that's deployed in a resource group and contains a network security group. Finally, this is optional, you can install the Azure Security Center PowerShell module I wrote, which makes it easy to set and invoke JIT policies on your VM without needing to log into the portal. Here we are in the Azure Security Center portal. Now the first thing you'll want to do is turn on JIT as part of your prevention policy. So we'll select the policy tile. Next we select the subscription for where we want to have JIT enabled, and it will apply to all of the resource groups you see in this subscription. Let's select ASC Demo. And then we'll select Prevention Policy. And in our Prevention Policy, in the list near the bottom, you see JIT Network Access. So once this is turned on, you will now start to see recommendations for virtual machines that should have JIT turned on. Now let's come back to our main blade, and this time we're going to click on the Just-in-Time VM Access tile. There are three tabs in the JIT pane. There's Configured to show you virtual machines that are currently configured with JIT policies. There's Recommended, these are virtual machines that your prevention policy has said should have JIT enabled. And there are those that have no recommendation. These are VMs that may not have JIT enabled as part of its prevention policy, or perhaps they were deployed without a network security group, a public-facing IP, or they were deployed as a classic virtual machine. Let's go ahead and take a look at the settings for one of these VMs. We'll go ahead and select our 2012 R2 machine and click Edit. Now when we click Edit, this pulls up another blade that shows port 3389 is currently configured for 3 hours. Now, if we wanted to add, say, another port to this configuration, we could easily click Add and specify all the relevant information. And like I said, this isn't just for management ports. We could do, say, port 25 on TCP, and we could do it for a custom CEDAR block, and we can change that IP address range to anything we want it to be, meaning that only users within that range can even request access to that VM. So this is a way to lock down the ports even further, even when the window's open. Now, we can go ahead and tune this all the way down to 1 hour or all the way up to 24 hours or anything in between. Once we've specified all these settings, we can click OK, and this appends it to our list. Now all we have to do is click Save, wait for it to be appended to our rule set. And now we can go check our NSG and see that the new rule has just appeared as another deny rule. Something I want you to notice here is that the priority of the rules that were recently set are priorities 1000 and 1001. And then we have some other inbound allow rules that are running at around 1200 or so. This means that if you have an inbound RDP rule that allows access at, say, priority 1, that will supersede any of these ASC rules. So you want to make sure you're following best practices and doing your allow rules at a lower priority and your deny rules at a higher priority. This will become more important later when we actually invoke access and we see the priority that those rules run at. Let's validate that our deny rule is working for RDP by trying to log in. And as you can see, it's just going to hang here. So the next thing we need to do is request access to this VM for a period of time. Let's see how to do that. Here we are back in the JIT portal, and now we're going to click Request Access. So there are our two ports, but we care about port 3389. So let's go ahead and request access. Now we can do this for either our specific IP address or for a whole range of IPs, which means that while this window is open, any IP addresses within this range will be able to access. So we configured our policy to allow for anything on this block, so we could open it up for this entire block, or we could simply do star for everything. We can configure our time from anywhere between 1 to 3 hours. And so let's go ahead and turn it on for just our IP address. So we'll toggle it on and click open ports. We wait just a few seconds, and then the ports will be open. Now that our request is active, we can go ahead and log in. So I hope you see how easy this is to do through the console, but let's now pivot over and see how we can do it from the command line through PowerShell. To follow along with this part of the video, you'll need to run install-module Azure RM and install-module Azure Security Center to install both of those modules from the PS gallery, if you have not already done so. Now we simply run login-azure RM account to log into our Azure subscription. I'll go ahead and speed this part up. If you're like me and you have multiple subscriptions, you may not automatically land in the subscription that you want to administer. So go ahead and run set-azure RM context plus your subscription name to switch the context of your PS session to the new subscription. Using our new commandlets, let's go ahead and set a JIT access policy for one of our VMs. So we'll run set-asc JIT access policy, specify our resource group name, specify our virtual machine name, the port or ports that we want open, so we specify 3389 here, the protocol, star being both, but we'll say TCP, and the allowed source address prefix. This could be star or this could be a block. In this case, I have a special function called getMyIP, which retrieves my existing IP address from a RESTful service. All that's left to do is specify that maximum window of time that an administrator needs to abide by when requesting access. We'll specify 24 hours. After wait a couple seconds, now we'll see that our JIT policy has been set for this VM. So let's hop back into the portal and verify that it is in fact showing up under the Configure tab. And in fact, we do see it in our Configure tab. So let's validate that this is working by trying to log into our VM, and hopefully we'll get denied. Let's go ahead and close our current connection to the domain controller, and now let's try to log into the client machine. And as you can see, it's hanging. So we'll go ahead and close this, and let's hop back into PowerShell and see how we can request access. Now that we want to request access, we can run invoke-asc-jit-access, and just like before, we need to specify the resource group name, our virtual machine name, our source address prefix, the port number, as well as the window of time. Let's do a really short window of time for this example. How about 10 minutes? So I'm going to specify hours as 0 and minutes as 10. And just for fun, take note of the time in the lower right corner. It's 1:39, almost 1:40. We'll see in a minute why this is important. Let's hop back in the console for just a moment and take a look at our temporary rule. And here we see our new temporary rule running at a very high priority, priority 100. After 10 minutes or so, this rule will age off and then disappear from our NSG. All that's left to do is to go check and see if we can log in. Great, and we're all logged in. And remember, we set our window of time for 10 minutes. And if you also remember, I had you look at the clock and we saw that it said roughly 1:40. Let's jump ahead to 1:50 and see what happens in our NSG. Here we are back at our NSG, and note the time, it's about 1:50, and we set our policy at around 1:40. Let's take a look and see what happens to our temporary rule. And just like that, it's gone. And now our machine is back to a default deny state for RDP until the next time an administrator needs to request access. I want to thank you for watching this video, and I encourage you to join the CXP security community. You can see our technical previews, speak directly to our engineering teams, myself included, and ultimately help influence our product direction. For more information, just visit aka.ms/security community. Thank you so much and have a great day.